The temperature of regular stuff is basically just a measurement of the jiggliness of the atoms and molecules that make that stuff up. More jiggling, higher temperature. Less jiggling, lower temperature. Of course, when something's at a high temperature, it feels hot, and when something's at a low temperature, it feels cold. Right? Not exactly. If you touch a piece of metal and a book that have been sitting in your fridge, the metal will feel much colder than the book. Derek of Veritasium did a great video on this, but you really have to try it for yourself to believe it. The metal and the book are honestly at the same temperature as measured by a thermometer, but the metal feels colder. This isn't just a trick of the mind, though. We experience the metal as colder than the book for a very physical reason. Metal is a conductor, and paper is an insulator, so the energy or jiggliness of the molecules in our hands is absorbed more quickly by the metal than by the book. Even though the book and the metal are at the same temperature, the metal causes the temperature of our hands to go down faster, and thus we experience the metal as being colder, because the temperature of our hands is what we really feel. It's like how technically a mercury thermometer really only measures its own temperature, and you can only indirectly measure temperatures of other things by putting them in thermal contact with it. Similarly, the thermoreceptive nerves in our skin can only directly measure the temperature of the skin itself and not of anything else. So when we touch something, we don't feel its temperature, but rather we feel its effect on our skin. That is how much and how quickly it transfers thermal energy, that's the jiggling of molecules, to or from us. The capacity to transfer thermal energy is also why a blast of steam from your stovetop can feel so much hotter than a blast of hot, dry air from your oven, even if the oven has a higher temperature. Water vapor transfers more molecular jiggling to your skin than air by itself. In fact, it's tempting to say that hot and cold are fundamentally different concepts from high temperature and low temperature, even though we usually use the words interchangeably. Hot really means it gives off a lot of energy, while high temperature means it has a lot of energy. And as anyone who's tried fundraising knows, just because somebody has a lot of something doesn't necessarily mean they give a lot of it away. This Minute Physics video was brought to you by Squarespace, the all-in-one platform that makes it fast and easy to create a professional website, blog, portfolio, or online store. Basically, they let robots do the robot work of building and managing your website and leave the exciting and creative parts to you. For a free trial and 10% off your first purchase on new accounts, go to squarespace.com and use offer code MINUTEPHYSICS5. Again, thanks to Squarespace for supporting this episode of Minute Physics.